All right, so we're going to integrate x squared plus 4 over the quantity 2x squared plus x. And noticing that the degree of the numerator is the same as the degree of the denominator, we're going to need long division here to start. So we're going to go ahead and divide 2x squared plus x into x squared. Notice we have 0 x's here, so I'm going to go ahead and write 0 x plus 4. So we ask, what times 2x squared gives me x squared? And the answer is a half. So 1 half times 2x squared is x squared. 1 half times x is 1 half x. And then we are going to subtract this line from the previous. So x squared minus x squared is 0. 0 minus a 1 half x is negative 1 half x. Bring down the 4. And at this point, we've reduced it. And so now we've got 1 half as the whole part plus negative 1 half x plus 4 over 2x squared plus x. Now, looking at our denominator, first thing we might think is substitution, but if we let u equal that, the derivative is not going to be the top. And so what we really need here is to notice that we can factor an x out of the denominator, which suggests that we can use partial fractions here. So we're going to go ahead and break apart now negative 1 half x plus 4 over x times 2x plus 1 as some constant over x plus some constant over 2x plus 1. So we're going to start out by clearing out our fractions here. So we're going to multiply both sides times the common denominator. And when we do that, when we multiply this times the left side, the entire denominator cancels. When we multiply this times the a over x terms, the x's cancel, and 2x plus 1 remains multiplying a. When we multiply here, the 2x plus 1 cancels, and the x remains multiplying b. Now, there's a couple different tactics we can take here. We're going to take the tactic of picking some values for x. So notice that if x was 0, this term would go away. So I'm going to let x equal 0. And then on the left, we get 0 times a half is a 0, plus 4 is 4. This term again is 0. Plugging in 0 here, 2 times 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 times a. Great, a is 4. Now we can pick any other value of x that we'd like. But again, it'd be convenient if one of these terms went away. So if I let x equal negative 1 half, notice that this term will end up being 0. So letting x equal negative 1 half, negative 1 half times a negative 1 half is a positive 1 quarter, plus 4 equals, again, this term is 0, that's a negative 1 half b. Combining that, that's 17 fourths equals negative 1 half b, multiplying both sides by negative 2 gives me b is negative 17 halves. So putting these now as the terms there, this is going to become 1 half plus 4 over x plus negative 17 halves over 2x plus 1. And we'll continue this question in the next video. And so now we're going to continue this and actually do the integration. So integrating 1 half, we know what the integral 1 half is. It's just 1 half x. Here, integrating 4 over x, we can pull out the 4. Integral of 1 over x is ln. So we get 4 natural log of x. And here, this one might require a little more work because of the 2x plus 1 in the bottom. So we can pull out the negative 17 halves, get it out of the way. And we're integrating 1 over 2x plus 1 dx. And technically, we're going to be using a substitution here. So we're going to go ahead and let u equal 2x plus 1, du equals 2 dx. So dx is du over 2. And making that substitution, this becomes integral of 1 over u du over 2, right? Because the 1 over 2x plus 1 is 1 over u, dx becomes du over 2. We can take out that extra over 2, multiply it in with 17 halves. Integral of 1 over u, and integral of 1 over u will be natural log of u. Back substituting gives us what we were looking for, natural log of u, which was 2x plus 1 plus c. There is our general antiderivative for the, remember the rational expression we started with there.